Stephen Colbert and Jimmy Kimmel, discussed a new book reporting Steve Bannon's attacks on Donald Trump Jr. and Jared Kushner. Late-night hosts on Wednesday discussed the revelations in a new tell-all book by Michael Wolff about the Trump campaign and administration. According to a new book called Fire and Fury, Donald Trump Didn't He Want to Be President? Began Stephen Colbert. He didn't he want himself to win. There is a name for that, the majority of American voters. Trump was planning on failing and walking away with the fame and the money, the host went on. Or, as the article described it, this was a real-life version of Mel Brooks's The Producers. Donald Trump Jr. told a friend that, on election night, his father looked as if he'd seen a ghost. Melania was in tears, and not of joy. Melania cried on election night? That is the first thing we have in common. Other than, of course, our smoky eyes. Colbert summarized more of the book's contents, including comments by Rupert Murdoch. During the transition, Trump called Murdoch to float an immigration plan that Murdoch thought would alienate his base, Colbert said. When he got off the phone, Murdoch reportedly shrugged and said, "What a fucking idiot." Colbert continued, "Two things, Mr. Murdoch. One, you were an Australian. You have no right to talk about our president that way. And two, is Australia currently accepting applications? Because I've heard our president is a fucking idiot." Comedy Central's Trevor Noah focused on the president's Twitter activity in the new year, which has seen him compare the size of America's nuclear button to North Korea's. Apparently, President Trump's New Year's resolution was, "I should spend more time on Twitter," Noah said, reading Trump's tweet to Kim Jong-un aloud. "I know that Donald Trump is trying to be menacing here, but all I hear is a really catchy pop song. My button brings all the boys to the yard, and they re like, it's bigger than yours. If you had a supercomputer that could run a simulation to find the stupidest possible way to get into a nuclear war, this tweet is what would come up every single time," the host joked. Noah continued, "Take a step back, and think about what pressing the button would actually mean. Hundreds of thousands of people incinerated instantly. And they would be the lucky ones. Millions more would die horribly in the next few weeks, while any survivors would be left to suffer in the desolate world that is choked by poison ash. That's not for Twitter,